Hey, and welcome back to the Life Work Balance YouTube channel. Today I would like to share with you one key resource for enhancing your job search strategy. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button as well as the bell so that you can receive Life Work Balance advice delivered directly to you every Sunday. So when it comes to job searching, there's a lot of research that you should be doing on the front end to prepare yourself for the interview process, for salary negotiation, and to just give yourself a better picture of what it is that you're looking to do and what's required of the job. This is more than just reading a job description and applying to a job. So there's this resource that's actually available from the U.S. Department of Labor, and it's called ONET. The website is onetonline.org, and it is the key to the success of your job search strategy. So what is ONET and how do you use it? Well, ONET, like I said earlier, is sponsored by the U.S. Department of Labor. When you navigate to onetonline.org, you'll be brought to their home screen. From the home screen, you'll be able to do an occupation quick search right here. You'll be able to do research about what potential careers are out there and what you might be able to do next using the My Next Move option. There's special resources for military veterans, and there's also hot technologies, which are frequently included in employer job postings, which helps you determine which certifications or programs you should learn that can help you the best. But the most important aspect of ONET, from my perspective, is the occupation search. So you can use the occupation quick search just up here at the top right of the screen, or you can also type in a keyword search here in the middle of your screen. So I'm just going to go up here to the occupation quick search, and I'm going to type project manager. From here, this displays the top 20 occupations for project manager, with the closest occupations at the top and those that are not as closely related towards the bottom. However, you can see that there are over 876 occupations that are related to the search project manager available in ONET. ONET is basically a database of all of the different career areas that could be available to you. All right, so let's just click on the very first one, wind energy project managers. You can see there are different icons next to some of these jobs. The leaf and green shows that this is a sustainable job. It's environmentally friendly. And then we've got the bright outlook icon as well, which is indicating that there's likely going to be an increase in demand for these types of jobs. So let's click wind energy project managers, and this will bring us to the general overview of a wind energy project manager. So at the top, we've got the summary report for the wind energy project managers. It gives us a basic overview of what this position does, and then a sample of reported job titles. So someone who is a wind energy project manager may also be called a business developer, a business development director, a renewable project management and construction director. So these are samples of reported job titles that fall within this group, wind energy project managers, that also includes project management. So from here, we can see the different tasks, technology skills, and tools that are required for the specific job. It goes dives deep into knowledge, skills, abilities, work activities, detailed work activities, work context, job zone, education credentials, interest, work styles, work values, wages and employment, and job openings. So from here, this is a great way for you to begin tailoring your resume and use some of the keywords that would be required for a job that's in this area. This will also give you a good idea of if you're truly interested in this job or not. If you read through some of these tasks and technology skills, the knowledge, skills, and abilities required to be successful for a job in this area, and it bores you to tears and you say, that's something I'm not interested in doing, or that sounds like that would be really boring, or I don't want to be doing that on a daily basis, and that's a good way to also narrow down your job areas so that you can focus your job search. You can see that they've got five of each of these areas displayed, but you know there are many that are available. So for example, with the task, they've displayed five, but there are 15 tasks available. So you can dive deep into this, and you can use that to inform your job search process, your resume rewrite, as well as how you might answer some interview questions. Same thing with some of the technology skills. This tells you what areas you need to be proficient in order to be successful in this type of position. The knowledge, skills, and abilities that are required for success in a position like this. Again, these are important key words that you can use to plug into your resume, your cover letter, and that you can use during the interview process. We can move down here to work activities and detailed work activities, as well as work context. And this will let you know what a day in the life or a week in the life of someone who does this type of work looks like. So there's a lot of communication with people from outside of the organization. So if you are more of an introvert and you don't like communicating with other people all that often, then this might not be a good fit for you. However, if you're an extrovert and communicating with people outside of your work group on a regular basis is appealing to you, then this could be a great fit. The job zone area is also an area where you want to focus some of your time. So the title of this job zone is Job Zone 4, which shows that considerable preparation is needed to be successful in a career like this. So this is not an entry-level job. It also gives us some insight into the education that's required for this job. A bachelor's degree is typically required, but some of these occupations don't require a bachelor's degree. There's a lot of related work experience that's required for this position. Job training required for this. Typically, employees need several years of work-related experience in order to be a wind energy project manager. And then we've also got some job zone examples, which shows that many of the occupations that are involved in wind energy project management involve coordinating, supervising, managing, and training others. So you need to have likely good communication skills, good management skills, and then also gives you some other examples of areas where those skills are important. This also dives deep into the education breakdown of the majority of people who fall into this work group. So the majority of people have bachelor's degrees, so 67% of people have bachelor's degrees. 18% have an associate's degree, and 12% have a master's degree. If this requires any credentialing, you could click on the training to figure out what credentialing is required. You could also find certifications, and there are some apprenticeship opportunities as well. If you're wondering if this is something that would interest you, take the O-Net Interest Profiler, and that will allow you to discover your interests, which you can then match up with each of the interests in each job area. So the interests associated with this particular job profile include enterprising, conventional, and investigative. If you want to know more about that, please go ahead and take that O-Net Interest Profiler. It's available for free for anyone to use. They've also got the work styles and work values for this position or positions similar to this. And then here's one of my favorite areas of O-Net. This is the secret hidden gem that a lot of people don't know about that I highly recommend for my clients to use when it comes to doing research on the salary for the positions they're applying to. This gives you the median wages from 2019 for someone in this type of position. You can see what they make from an hourly basis as well as from an annual basis. However, you can dive much deeper into the analysis of the wages that are available for these types of positions. So I recommend selecting your state. So for me, we're in Colorado, and I'm going to go ahead and select go. And this will bring you to a new page. This page displays the data that compares the United States salary information compared to Colorado's specific salary information. So for the United States, the low end of the salary is $53,380 per year. The high end is all the way up to $191,340 per year. And the average that people make in this job in the United States is $110,630 per year. However, if you look right below that, it gives you the detailed information for your state in particular. On average, in Colorado, workers earn $131,460 per year. That's about $20,000 more than the U.S. on average. We also can see the low end, which is $76,000, all the way up to the high end, which is about $208,000. If you scroll down, it actually gives you full details for areas that are in Colorado as well, the annual low, as well as the annual high, as well as the annual median or average. When you go back to the main page in O-Net for that particular job area, you will also see job openings on the web. If you click find jobs, it will likely ask you for your location so it can narrow down the search for that area. And there may be jobs that are posted, there may not be jobs that are posted. But that's what O-Net's program is pulling. So if nothing is pulled, that doesn't mean that there's no jobs available. It just means you may need to use a different platform. So that was just a brief overview on how to use O-Net to better inform your job search strategy. I highly recommend you use it at least for the salary negotiation phase of your job search, but if you can use it for the entire process to inform how you write your resume, how you write your cover letter, how you answer interview questions and use some of those key words during your interview prep, as well as to just do general research on the positions that might be out there to determine if that would be a good fit for you. I highly recommend Onet for those job search strategies. Now, if you have any questions about how to use Onet or you would like some specialized help on how to do this, please go ahead and contact me directly. You can also put a comment in the comments box and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you have questions about this, please put them in the comments below. And again, if you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button as well as the bell so that you can receive life-work balance advice delivered directly to you every Sunday. Next week, stay tuned as I'm going to dive deep into how you can use LinkedIn for your job search process. So please remember to hit that subscribe button so you can get that delivered directly to you next week. If you found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, remember, drop them in the comments below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you, and I'll see you next week.